My name is Luke McKenzie, and I draw a comic strip. I started 5 years ago in high school. I don't really remember why. And then I came to college. I've drawn a new comic for every issue of the school paper ever since, once every 2 weeks. Step one, procrastinate. I am really good at this. I often spend this time perusing other comics, you know, for research. But I also keep on top of a number of webcomics. After spending way too much time reading other people's comics, I realize I still have to do my own. So we move swiftly into step two, pre-production. I usually carry around a sketchbook where I jot down all my awesome ideas. So I flip through it furiously until I find one I haven't used yet. And I doodle around with it until I hit on a workable joke. Step three is penciling. I bust out the Bristol paper and sketch the comic in green pencil. This is the part that takes the most time. And after I'm done with that, step four is inking. There are a number of ways to do this. I've tried gel pens, ink and brushes, artist's pens. I've even tried inking on the computer with a graphics tablet. For today's comic, I wanted to try something really old school. Nib pens. I put the nibs in an ultrasonic cleaner to dissolve all the dried ink. Oh, this is nice. I could get used to this. Step five is post-production, all done on the computer. If you're wondering why I use green pencil, it's because my scanner scans black and white images with only green light. So the pencil lines don't show up in the scan, and I don't have to erase them. What's left of my eraser is thankful. I correct my inking mistakes in Photoshop with the graphics tablet. It's a lot easier than whiteout. If the comic isn't destined for coloring, I fill some areas with black. If it is meant for coloring, I make a new layer and fill that layer in with the tablet. When I'm all done, I take it to the Mercury. The graphics editor places it on the cartoons page. And when the paper comes out the next Monday, there it is in print for all the world to see. But I've kind of grown tired of drawing it by now. And I think I know why. I've concentrated on the art, but comics are essentially a storytelling medium. And if there's anything webcomics have taught me, it's that you don't really need good art. But you do need good stories. And I think I've neglected that. Maybe I have to go sequester myself in the middle of nowhere to come up with a good story. I just haven't done that yet. Even so, I'm proud of my work, and as long as it keeps making people laugh, I'll keep drawing it.